send-off package that would see 349 members of parliament and some 67 senators cost taxpayers a total of 3.3 billion shillings at the end of their term. The MPs have staked a claim on the money, arguing that they would be 8 months short of their full five-year term by the time parliament dissolves to pave way for the August polls. The MPs are said to have exerted pressure on the National Treasury Cabinet Secretary Henry Rotich to include their proposal in the 2017-2018 budgetary projections, threatening to shoot down the budget motion if he failed to factor in their money. But these pay demands are not in isolation. Doctors and lecturers too are currently on strike demanding better pay. The lady I'm about to introduce is at the center of all these talks. Joining me now is Salaries and Remunerations Chair Sarah Serem. We also have in studio activist Boniface Mwangi, who will be joining in the conversation a little later. Sarah, good morning. I'll start with you, and in particular with the doctors and lecturers issue. Do you believe at all that perhaps it's surprising that we've seen these two sets of industrial action carry on so long in an election year? Was this something you, as the chair of the Remuneration Commission, were expecting to happen at this time?
And this is indeed very surprising to us, because the whole purpose of bringing SRC into play was to manage the insanity that was existing within the administration of remuneration. And to see these two bodies, critical players in the public sector, out there in the streets, is really a very unfortunate situation. And of course, tying it up with electioneering year, and the fact that we're looking at how much we can rip out of a situation like this, is a very unfortunate thing to the Kenyans. And surprising to us, because we've started setting up systems, and we will tell you for a fact that the minute you move out of the structured way of managing remuneration, so that we get back to the individual setting, the silo running off of determination and pushing for parts and for benefits outside the structured way, is creating chaos, and that's what we are seeing now.
All right, Sarah, we understand that after this interview, we'll be heading for the mediation talks with doctors in particular. Do you have anything new to offer them? What are your expectations?
Absolutely not. By the way, as I'm sitting here, my vice and the CEO of SRC are already sitting in the mediation team. Mediation here is to clearly express our position as SRC, which we have done over and over to many bodies that have stepped in to mediate on this matter. And our position is perfectly clear. If the same advice was taken right from the very beginning, I think we would have solved this problem. But the moment we open our windows so that everybody is engaged in matters of remuneration, and we imagine that every window that we open perhaps will have an additional offer to give, that's where we go wrong. If we were to maintain remuneration as structured by the Constitution, we would have avoided this situation.
So nothing new for doctors.
Absolutely not.
Today. But I'll take you to a more broader topic, because when you look at these different groups that ask for better pay, they hinge their arguments often on one thing, that Kenya can actually afford to pay its workers better if it was to cut down on graft. What do you say to such an argument?
SRC works on the revenues that are clearly indicated and given to us. We work very closely with Treasury. And as we are talking now, the wage bill to revenue is at 52%. That is unacceptable. That is something we can avoid. If we're talking about issues of craft, we have no control over that, because that is not the role of SRC. And if there are systems that are looking at the issues of craft, then that needs to be tied up so that we have enough at the, you know, accessible for payment of remuneration. But even that, taking into account, we are already way above what we should be consuming, bearing in mind that the team we are talking about are under 2% of the total population. If we were to close out on all those ranks and we generate more revenue, I think much of it should be channeled into development as
all right,
opposed
Sarah,
to consumption.
Fair enough. I'm going to bring in Boniface Mwangi into our conversation shortly, but before I do that, since this position of the SRC was created and your chairmanship began, whenever we hear of industrial action, there's often the question of harmonization of job groups, etc., salaries and allowances. How far has the commission gone in as far as harmonizing this across the civil service?
We have done tremendous work. When we stepped in, we did a harmonization of the public sector salary. And over time, like in 2014, we harmonized allowances. 2015 starting, we did a job evaluation. The job evaluation results are amazingly a transformation, because we have valued every position within the public sector and given an opportunity, and we are pushing this agenda to the extreme end of it. We have evaluated every position and therefore harmonized the salaries within the public sector. All these other additional benefits offered outside the structure of SRC is what is creating disparity.
All right, let me bring in activist Boniface Mwangi into the conversation. Good morning, Boniface. And to the extent that you've built your career, I mean, at least over the last few years, around activism, and very vocally, I believe, was part of a group that coined the perhaps somewhat derogatory phrase MPigs, and now we have MPs again saying that they need to be paid a total of about 3.3 billion shillings. That's what it will cost the taxpayers, saying that they deserve this because they will miss a few months to the end of their term. What are your thoughts on this latest wading into, you know, demands for better pay?
I think that's total theft. When they were first elected, the first thing they did in parliament was to get a pay increase, which we resisted. And I think SRC failed because they gave them the money they really wanted. I think for a poor country like Kenya, we shouldn't be giving money to parliamentarians. When you go to parliament, you're going to serve the public, not to steal from the public. But you've seen this parliament has been very, very keen on trying to enrich themselves. They got 5 million car grant in a very poor country. We give you a salary and buy you a car. So I'm totally against it. And I'm actually running for MP to ensure that they don't do such things. And I think what these things fail, the biggest failure at the moment, is that when Uhuru had a chance to say no to the salary increment, he did not say that. So you can't have guys earning so much money in a very, very poor, in a very poor country. Your average salary for a house girl today is 3,000 shillings. Then you pay someone up to 2 million shillings. They should be satisfied with the money they've been given and not ask for more.
What are your thoughts in terms of the performance of bodies such as SRC and other government stakeholders, if you like, in terms of mediating industrial talks? We've seen you rather vocal in terms of the turn that the doctor's strike has taken and how long it has gone on. What's your thoughts in terms of their performance?
I think SRC has failed for failing to harmonize the salaries, number one. Number two, for allowing to be blackmailed by parliamentarians. And number three, she says that it's not her responsibility to fight corruption, but you understand that a third of our budget, about 600 billion shillings every year, is lost through corruption. So if we actually stop the corruption, we'll be able to pay people well. But if we want to be able to get people to reason with us, the doctors should be reasonable, and every other person who's actually going on strike, the lecturers, reduce the salaries of members of parliament by 50%.
All right, so
harmonization means that reduce the salaries to a level where it is understandable. If they work well and they perform very well, then you can give them a pay raise. But at this particular moment, they earn too much money. You should actually be asking for a refund before they go home.
Okay, you should demand a refund from the MP. Sarah, do you want to weigh in on that before we move on?
Yes, indeed. I would tell you, Anne, that there is no position as of now that we have compensated without conducting a job evaluation. If you checked what the parliamentarians are earning, the real salary set by us is within the minimum wages that we did set. The abuse is when they go out of their way, like making claims that are not warranted. They are going into trips that, of course, SRC has no control over. Mm-hmm. If you were to move to the salaries that were set by SRC, and they make their claims based on that structured pay, I would tell you there is fairness in it.
All right.
However, mm-hmm. we are moving in now to reset the same salary. If you look at our mandate, we set and regularly review. We're moving in to review the very same benefits again.
And can you reduce the salaries then? If you're going to harmonize, can you reduce members of parliament salaries and the president and the governor? We're in a poor country.
Let's harmonize it downwards.
Yes, not upwards.
Yes. Good point, good point. Hold that thought. Okay,
yeah.
Sarah, thank you very much for your time. We're staying with activist Boniface Mwangi, who's taking a turn for politics. He'll tell you which party he's running on and why would he wade into that debate. We'll be talking with Boniface a little later. But let's switch gears now and take you to...